and welcome to Math Homework Hotline, where we do the math. I'm Canella Prado.
I'm Carrie Shawshak, and tonight our theme is, can you guess? The Lightning.
Go Bolts. All right. It's fun. It's always fun to honor our sports teams here in Tampa. So get on those phones right now. Call 813-840-7260. We have a slew of excellent teachers back there to help you with all of your math questions. So whatever homework you got today, you can get help with right now on the phone. So again, call 813-840-7260. And remember, you can watch us on TV, Spectrum Channel 635, Frontier Channel 32, or just stream. Streaming is popular right now at www.mathhomeworkhotline.com. We've got a few, but that Math Homework Hotline is one of the easy ones to remember. So, and let's talk about those phone calls. There's lots of things that you could win. You could win by being a caller. You could be randomly chosen to win a Math Homework Hotline t-shirt here. It's our beautiful vintage Math Homework Hotline t-shirt. And also, by calling in, you're going to help your teacher possibly win one of these. It's a Gemmy Award. We have a competition every 3 weeks. Tonight is the last competition, so the totals from the last 2 weeks and tonight, whatever teacher has the highest calls from her highest period will win some food. And at last I checked, middle schoolers like to eat something.
They, yes, sure they do.
They're growing like weeds. That's why, right? So call in, get your teacher the plaque, and get yourself possibly a t-shirt and possibly some great food from like Chipotle or PDQ. So anyway, that's what's going on. What else do we got tonight?
So
let's talk about our topic.
Tonight our topic is angles. Well, kind of like angels, but
let's get the graphic up too. What is our topic?
It is angles and triangles. That's one of my favorite things to teach.
Yeah.
So yes, tonight we're going to work with angles. We're going to work with triangles. We're going to find some missing angle values. We're going to do all kinds of fun things, and we're going to review some of the vocabulary. It's going to be really fun.
Yes, that's true. I always say that they're a little bit like if you enjoy working puzzles like Sudoku, or did I say that right?
I think so, yeah. Sudoku, that's how I say it.
They're very similar to that. Once you understand the relationships, if you know one,
you can find
the other through some different things. So, okay, so that's our topic. Let's now talk about our challenge question. Let's go right to it. Get your phones out so that you can see. Get ready to take a photograph, right? Because you want to take a photograph, screen grab something, so you can work out tonight's Mathnasium and Edgems challenge question. Let's see that question
Let's
now.
Let's roll that question. All right, tonight's challenge problem question says, the measure of angle 1 is 12 more than the measure of angle 2. What is the degree measure of angle 3? So
I hope they're getting a picture of that so they can see.
Yeah,
those
you definitely
angle relationships down there. It starts on the left with angle 1, and then it just kind of goes clockwise 2, 3, 4. So that's a really great challenge problem. I love that.
I love that question. It's going to be a lot of fun for them to answer.
It's going to be a lot of fun to solve. I'm excited. All right, but let's talk about, hey, what do they win?
So
what do they win? If they actually are the caller that calls in, what do they get?
Let's take a look at these cool items that you have that you guys can win when you call in and you answer the challenge question correct. So the first thing that we have is a Mathnasium certificate. It's good for a free diagnostic test. It's a great value. It's awesome. We have a really fun game. It's a math game. It's called Canoodle. It's a lot of fun to play. We have an awesome bag. I love the bag. It has our new logo on it, the Math Homework Hotline. It can carry all of your things. An awesome Mathnasium water bottle. Thank you to Mathnasium for sponsoring us, of course. A little post-it note from Edgems. Also, thank you, Edgems. I love foam dye. These are fabulous. Get one of those. And of course, we would be remiss if we did not show you our awesome t-shirts. I love wearing mine every Thursday to school to advertise our show. And you also get your very own plaque. It'll come with your name on it, and you will get...
And your school name.
Your school name, and you get some special visitors, too, usually,
That's
to come and deliver
to come
the plaque.
And present these. Speaking of that, let's talk about last week's winner. I think we have a photograph, don't we, of our last week's winner?
Oh, yes, I think we do.
Well, our winner from our last show was actually not last week. It was February 9th.
Yeah,
it was
night.
Our 14th Student Jimmy Award winner. And let's see. Oh, look, there's Asher.
Oh, so
I
cute.
Love it.
I love it.
And he's got his bag. That's awesome. So Asher from Miss Ferguson's class at Williams Middle Magnet IB. Congratulations, Asher. I love that photo.
I do too. I love that.
Yeah, and remember, you answer tonight's challenge question. Be the first one. You're going to win all that. You're going to get your picture on TV, and we're going to talk about you. So remember, keep calling in for your teacher, too.
Yes.
Besides winning random T-shirts, you can also, being a random winner of a T-shirt, you can also get that food for your class and that plaque for your teacher. Tonight's the last night of the current competition. Next week, we'll start a new one. Okay, so let's see, what else do we have going on? Oh, I want to give a quick shout out. I want to show y'all my T-shirt here, okay? Melanie, who is Evan's mom from my third period, made this T-shirt. This is a custom-made Lightning T-shirt. She also sent the hat in, and then one of my students, Olivia, sent these flags in. So I really appreciate when kids help bring in things to help decorate the set. And I don't mind the free T-shirt either, I'm going to be honest with you. So thank you to Olivia, Melanie, and Evan, or EJ. His little nickname is EJ.
I love that. Well, and I have a shout out too, because I have a secret. I am not a Lightning fan. I am a St. Louis Blues fan, but
ooh,
I do want to support our team tonight. So I reached out to my awesome art teacher, Miss LeGrand, and I need to give a shout out. Thank you for letting me borrow your shirt. I appreciate it. And she actually has conference night tonight, but her son is at home watching the show. So hey, Ian, tell your mom hi and thanks.
Hey, Ian. Okay, we also have one more picture we'd like to show. We just want to feature a teacher that we feel is really going above and beyond. So can we throw her photograph up there on the...
Yeah.
I believe we have a photograph. Oh, there she is. And look at her. She's wearing the Math Homework Hotline T-shirt. Don't you love it? This is Miss Essig, and she is from Barrington Middle, and she is proudly wearing our Math Homework Hotline T-shirt. So thank you for being a teacher champion out there. We have so many across our district, but we just wanted to take a moment and highlight her. So thanks a lot.
Yeah, thanks so much for supporting us.
Okay.
Love it.
Let's okay. So why don't we start with a wrap up? I mean, not a wrap up. That would be wrong. A warm up. The other kind of warm up. So, the other kind of up. All right. So if we can go to my board really quick. So we have to talk about angle relationships. So I have a few things to help kids remember. So I'm going to start out that complementary angles are 90 degrees. Okay? They add their sum equals 90 degrees. So you could have something, if it was be drawn, it would be like this. It would have this little square to indicate a right angle. And let's just say these are both, I don't know, this one looks a little bigger, so maybe 50 and 30. Obviously not drawn to scale, but that would be complementary. All right, supplementary, their sum, when you add their angles together, would equal 180 degrees. Okay, so this is a little trick that I teach the kids. Let me just start with explaining the supplementary a little bit more. So supplementary starts with an S, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I remember supplementary straight line.
Oh, I like that.
Supplementary would be a straight line. So let's say I'm going to just make it, I don't know, let's do this. Okay, we'll say this one is 40 degrees, and then that would make this one 140 degrees. So when you add them up, their sum will equal 180 degrees. So what I like to tell kids, another tip, is that they usually can remember that one equals 90 and one equals 180, but they can't remember which is which.
Right.
So I tell them that C comes before S.
That's what I do too.
C comes before S in the alphabet, and 90 comes before 180 on the number line in
right.
counting, right? So that's my little couple of my little tips and tricks. This S for straight line, S for supplementary, and C comes before S. Complementary is 90 and supplementary is 180. Now vertical, I would love to hear how you describe this, Ms. Shawshack, but I always say they're nose to nose.
Oh, that's cute. I like that.
They're nose to nose. Sometimes I even get graphic and draw a nostril. just to be silly. But they're nose to nose. And that's what I always say. So if their nose touches, if they're small little point touches, that means they're vertical, and that will make them congruent. And what the word congruent means, and whenever you see a little line on an angle like that, and it has like a single tick and another one that has a single tick, that means they're congruent. So vertical angles are always congruent, which means they are equal in measure. Equal in measure, okay? All right, so they are equal in measure. So vertical angles will always be congruent. Now let's talk about what do the angles of a triangle equal? Do you see I have a triangle here, okay? They always, when you sum them up, when your triangle angles will sum, will equal 180 degrees. Now I'm gonna show you something sort of fun. Here's my perfect triangle, okay? And we see angle 1, 2, and 3. Watch. How do you know, can I prove to you right now on live TV that these angles, which I numbered, remember I numbered them 1, 2, and 3, equal 180 degrees? That they would be supplementary then, okay? Look at that. I got a straight line.
I love that.
When you cut it up and put all the angles together like that, all of their tips together, they will be 100% in a straight line. So that proves that the angles will always equal 180 degrees. So therefore, they would be supplementary angles, right? Okay, I think we have a caller. Hi, is this Arian?
Yes.
Hi, Arian. Would you like to do a math problem with us tonight?
Yes.
Great.
That's awesome. Arian, I have a problem for you right here on my board that we're going to work together. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Awesome. So the question that we're going to look at today says that the measure of angle G is 82 degrees, and we want to find the measure of its supplement. So there's a couple things going on. I like to draw pictures of what this might look like. So I know that it's going to be supplementary, so it's going to make a straight line, right?
Yeah.
And I know it's 82 degrees, so again, it's not drawn perfectly to scale, but it's not quite 90, but it's definitely not an obtuse angle. So we're gonna call that 82 degrees. So how do you think, Arian, that we're gonna find this missing angle, the supplement?
I think I couldn't see the problem because, the show is like a little bit back.
Okay, so let me ask you this. So if we know that something is supplementary, what would be the total sum of the angle measures? That's right. The two angles have to add up to 180 degrees. So we would do 180 degrees is equal to... Right. So we would write our own little equation that we would add the two angles to get 180, which means we would do our inverse operation and subtract 82 from 180. And when we do that, what do we get?
98.
Awesome job. So we can always, if you want to check your work, you can always take the 98 and add it to the 82 and make sure that it is supplementary, that they add up to 180, just to double check yourself. So our supplement is equal to 98 degrees. Thank you so much for doing this problem with me. It was a lot of fun.
All right,
do you have a problem for us, Ms. Prado?
Oh, I sure do. Okay, so remember earlier I talked about complementary angles. So we're gonna look at some stuff on my board here and try to figure out what kind of angle these things are. Okay, it says, what is the relationship of the angles below? We're talking about these two beautifully drawn here.
Oh, those are nice.
One is 82 degrees and one is 8 degrees. So the first thing it says, what is the relationship? Well, is it supplementary? That's the first question. Remember we said supplementary would, the sum would equal 180 degrees. Well, 82 plus 8 is not 180. So definitely not. It's far from that. And then remember what I said about congruence. We talked about that vertical angles are congruent. Look, so the next one is vertical. So congruent means they would have the exact same equal measure. Okay? So 82 and 8 definitely aren't equal. 82 is way bigger than 8. So they are not equal. They're not equal. So that's a no. Okay? Are they vertical? Remember, I said vertical angles would be what? Nose to nose, right? They could be sideways like this, or they could be up and down, or they could be at a diagonal, but their angles would touch at the tip, nose to nose. Okay, so definitely these are not even together in any way, shape, or form. So that leaves us with complementary. And what I told you about complementary is they have to, sum must equal 90. So let's check. 82 plus 8 does in fact equal 90. It does in fact equal 90. So this is the winner. Ding, 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 ding. Winner, winner, chicken dinner going on over here. So the relationship between these two angles is complementary because their sum, when you add them together, equals 90. There you go.
Very nice job, Ms. Prado. I like it. All right, so we have another problem here, and it looks just a little bit different. We have two different angles, and one of them is 24 degrees, and the other one is 12 times x degrees. And we're trying to find what the value of just that little x is. So not the whole angle measure, but just that little x value. So the one thing that I'm going to notice is that I have the tick marks on the angle there, and it's showing me that they are congruent. So what that means when I go to solve this is that 12x has to be equal to 24 degrees. So this is a simple one-step equation at this point, so I'm just going to use the inverse operation and divide both sides of our equation by 12. And when I do that, x is equal to 2. And I look at my answer choices, and 2 is an answer choice. So it's really that simple.
And you could plug it in to check, right?
You absolutely could. We know that 12 times 36 is going to be much larger than 24. 12 times 12 is 144. I know that 12 times 5 is 60, so I know that's going to be way bigger just using estimation. And then 12 times 2, ding, ding, ding.
24. I like it because 24. I like how you used estimation because I think that's important, that sometimes you don't have a lot of time.
That's true.
You know, and you're running out of time, and so let's just use some math logic, do some estimating, and take it from there.
And I think it's super important to check for reasonableness, too.
Right.
You want to make sure that it's a reasonable answer. You don't want to just choose 36 because, well, I know that 36 is a factor or a multiple of 12, so that's got to be the answer.
Exactly. And I want to remind you all to keep calling in. Call us at 813-840-7260. Not only to get help with those math questions and to possibly win a t-shirt, but to help your teacher become that Gemmy Award winner, and you get some free PDQ, Chipotle. I think there's some Chick-fil-A in there. So just keep calling in. We'd love to hear from you. Okay, so, and we wanted that, we also want a, we want a challenge winner.
We do want a challenge winner. We have not had one yet.
Okay, so which equations could be used to solve for x on my board here? And it's a select all. Now, I like to practice select alls because I find that this is something that takes like a lot of practice and really thought. It's like higher order thinking, and kids need a lot of practice with it. So I'm going to start by looking at this and saying, okay, which equations could be used to solve for x? And we've got this angle of 108 degrees and this one of 4x plus 4. So I'm going to have to go back and say to myself, what relationship is going on here? Okay, and if you see, I'm going to grab a ruler. Look, I used a ruler to draw this line, so it actually works. These two angles are sitting on a straight line. And remember I told you, straight line automatically means it's supplementary. So that means that these two are supplementary. That means that they will sum or add to 180 degrees. So let's just start by writing it out. I'm going to write it out here. 108 plus 4x plus 4 will equal 180 degrees. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look over here because it's select all. So I'm going to start right there. And look, do I have any of these that look identical? And in fact, look, I do. We have 108 plus 4x plus 4 equals 180. And so we've got already, right off the bat, we know C is one of them. Now, the rest of them might look a little bit scary, but I'm telling you, solve. If you go ahead and solve, you will find the other answers. Now, I personally would combine like terms here and get 112.
Right.
But as I'm looking down here at my choices, there's no 112. So I'm like, okay, so they must have put them over there one at a time. So I'm going to say that they must have moved over the 108 possibly first. I'm going to see if that does anything. If I move over the 108, this, of course, would cancel, right? It would cancel on this side. And I'm going to stop for a second and go, do I see anything that looks similar? If I subtract 108 from both sides, I'm coming down here, and I'm like, oh, they subtracted 108 on D. See that? And guess what? They just canceled out this side. And look, we've got 4x plus 4 equals 180 minus 108. So D would fall in the middle of the next step, right? So let's go ahead and keep moving down. I'm going to bring down my 4x plus 4, and if I subtract 108 from 180, I know just right off the bat in my head that that is 72. You could use a calculator. You could work it out by hand, right?
Yeah, for sure.
You could do those things, but now I'm going to stop again and say, oh, look, I have a match. 4x plus 4 equals 72. So ding, 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 ding here. Now look, automatically, I can get rid of this one because it can't be 4x equals 72 and 4x equals 108. If it's one, it's by definition not the other.
For sure.
Because it can't equal both. All right. This is not an inequality. All right. And so the last thing I could solve, but look, it's not really asking me to solve all the way down, is it?
No, it's just asking to
exactly.
Simplify.
So if I continue on down, I'm not going to get x plus 108, so that's not it. But I don't know about you, Carrie, but I kind of can't stand that it's not solved.
I know, it kind of drives me crazy.
I know,
when
so I'm going to solve it. So you're going to subtract 4, and you're going to get 4x equals 68. And then it's a one-step equation, so you're going to divide by 4. You're going to divide by 4. And you're going to get what, x equals 17?
I think so.
Okay. All right, but as you can see, by doing it, now you could do all the work first. I was just identifying when we hit them as we went, but you could do all the work first and then go back and look and see. But when you have a select all with equations that could be used to solve, you know it's going to be part of the steps. And that was a big deal that I wanted you to understand tonight with this question. All right, I think we have a caller.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Hi, caller. Oh, it's a challenge winner.
Can I do it?
Yeah. All right. So, yay. Woo. Challenge winner. Okay. So, what's your name? Is it?
My name is Ashley. Could
you say it one more time, please?
Yes.
Okay. So, you are from Miss Hunt's class?
Yes.
At Williams. All yes. Right, let's go ahead then, and Miss Shawshack, Arnav, let's go ahead and have Miss Shawshack work the problem with you. You ready to tell her how you did it?
Yes.
Let's go.
Awesome. Let's go. All right. So if we'll look at the board here, we've got the question written down. The measure of angle 1 is 12 more than the measure of angle number 2. What's the measure of angle number 3? So what did you do first?
I did that.
All right, so that's right. So we know that x plus 12 equals 180 degrees.
Yes.
Awesome job. Because they are what we would call adjacent angles, they are next to each other and they form a linear pair, we know they're supplementary.
Yes.
Awesome job. So now, from this point, what would I do next?
I add a term with
x plus 12. Awesome. You combined your like terms. You got 2x plus 12 equals 180. We're looking at a two-step equation now. So then, what do we do next?
I did 1 plus 1 and I got 2 equals 1.
Awesome. So 2 times x equals 168. We're going to divide both sides by 2. And what did you get for the answer of x?
First, I got 84.
Awesome. So x is 84. Which means that
84. I add to 80 and got 96.
Awesome. Oops. My brain just worked a little bit faster here.
Happens. Happens to me a lot.
So you added 84 and 12 to get 96 degrees. So angle 1 is 96 degrees. And angle 1 and angle 3 are vertical angles. So what does that mean about angle 3? Awesome. That's right. It's going to be congruent to angle 1, so it will also be 96 degrees. Great job. We're so proud of you. Thank you for calling in, and your prizes will be coming soon.
I know. That's impressive. All right.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, Miss Hunt's going to be crazy proud. All right,
she really
now
is.
Let's talk about some T-shirt winners.
Oh,
Where's
I love
our
that.
Gorgeous T-shirt that we have to share here? All right, we have from Barrington, we have Andre, and from Walker, we have Nicholas. And let's not forget Daniel at Benito. Here's you're going to be, the shirt like this is coming your way. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Thanks for calling in.
Thanks for calling in. And keep those calls coming, guys. 813-840-7260. You want to make your teacher that Jemmy winner so you can get a little snacky poo. All right.
That's right.
Let's go. Let's now, and speaking of which, our Ed Gems winner, our Ed Gems challenges. Let's talk about Ed Gems, shall we?
I think so. Let's.
Here's a great one. The parent guide. I think that, you know, the parents, they can never actually get enough assistance. So this is an awesome thing. EdGems provides lots of things for parents, but the parent guide in particular is an overview of the unit expectations. It gives a clear explanation of the required thinking and learning skills to achieve targeted learning outcomes. Here tips are provided on how parents and caregivers can support their child at home, including suggested activities and points of discussion or engagement. Key vocabulary. Vocabulary is so critical to succeeding. If you read a vocabulary word and you don't know what it means, it's very unlikely that you're going to be able to solve correctly. So going over those key vocabulary things could be something you could do at dinner, in fact. So the address is the key vocabulary is addressed in the unit, is highlighted, as well as how the unit's concepts connect to previously learned material and future related material. And for teachers, this is just talking to the teachers out there, you can custom edit this.
Right.
Right, to be exactly what you think is the most important. Or if you want to add in, you can edit or add in, and you can make it totally editable, and you can send a link directly via email without the need for any sort of password, which is always parent-friendly to not need a password. It's actually teacher-friendly, too.
I agree with that. That is for sure.
Adult friendly in general to not need a password. All right. So thank you to EdGems for supporting us here, and the teacher winner and the weekly winner and Mathnasium too. We're going to talk about them and how wonderful they are in just a bit.
That's right. And thank you to our challenge winner for calling in too. All right. So we have a problem here that I want to look at, and we're going to look at the relationship again. We have vertical angles. And these two angles, because they're vertical, we know that they are going to be congruent. They're going to have the same measure. So when we read our question is, what is the value of x? So I'm not trying to find the angle measure. I'm just simply trying to find what the value of x is. So I'm going to go ahead, and I am going to write an equation based on what I know about vertical angles. So I'm going to have 13 plus 3x. Again, they're congruent, so I'm going to say equals 166 degrees. This is a two-step equation, so I need to go ahead and get rid of this 13. So I'm going to subtract 13 from both sides of my equation. I am left with 3 times x, or 3x. And this equals 153. And to find out what x is, I am going to have to divide by 3. And when I do that, x is equal to 51. So that is D. And we can eliminate each one of these if we substitute in, just to check our work. We know that 3 times 150 would be way too large. And then 3 times 56 is going to be, 168. So it's already larger than that angle. And so I like to check 55 times 3. Is 165, so adding 13 to that, way more than 166. So the correct answer is definitely 51.
Awesome. I think we have a caller to do a problem with us on air. Is this Oliver? Hi.
Yes.
Hi. Hi, Oliver. You're from York? Is that where you go to school?
Yeah.
Great. Okay, so Oliver, yeah. I'm going to explain something about triangles really quickly. Okay, and then we're going to do a problem together, all right? So I know your TV will run a little bit behind, so I'll start talking about this. Okay, so we have two straws here, okay? They're a yellow and a red straw. Can you see that they are the exact same length? Can you see that? They are the exact same length. So the rule is that triangles, the two shorter lengths of a triangle have to be, when you add them together, they have to be longer than the longest length, or else they will not form a triangle. As you can see here, these are the exact same length, and we can't form a triangle with it. Okay? We cannot form a triangle with it. But if you look here, I have a blue straw. See that? And these two orange straws, can you see that those two side lengths are, this orange straw, orange and pink actually, is longer than the blue straw? Do you see that? So these two sides here will add up to be longer than the third side. Understand? So when that one can make a beautiful triangle, do you see that? Because the two short sides add up longer than the longest side. These two short sides add up in length to be longer than the longest side. It makes a triangle. These two here add up to be the same length so that no triangle can be made. It's just completely flat. Understand? Have we lost Oliver?
Sounds like maybe.
I'm still here.
Okay, great. All right, so do you understand the two short sides have to add up to be longer than the longest side to form a triangle? Got it?
Yes.
All right, so if we take 4 and we, which is the short side, right? And 6, they're the two shorter sides. If we take 4 and we add 6 to it, is that greater than 9? Is 4 plus 6 greater than 9? It's, what does it equal? What's 4 plus 6?
10.
Awesome. 10 is greater than 9. So that one would be yes. This one will make a triangle. Okay? Now remember, we have to be greater than, not greater than or equal to, because my red and yellow straws here, they were equal to, right? And it doesn't work. All right, so we've got 5 and 10 are the smaller sides. If we take 5 and we add 10, is that going to be greater than 15?
No, it's
going to
be equal to.
Right, exactly. So this one is no, right? Close, but it didn't work out. Okay, how about 17 and 22? Let's see. Those are the short sides, right? 17 and 22. If we add 17 and 22, what do we get when we add 17 and 22?
39.
Perfect. So is 39 greater than 43?
No.
Okay. And then we've got 20 and 21. So what? Those are the short sides. If we add those together, 20 plus 21, will that be greater than 35?
Yes.
Because 20 plus 21 is what?
41.
41 is greater than 35. That is true, so that would be yes. So we have answered all 4, and you've done a great job explaining how the sets of lengths can tell you whether or not it will form a triangle. Okay? All right. Thank you so much for calling in.
You're welcome.
Have a great night. Hi, I think we have Mateo on the phone. Is this Mateo?
Yes.
Hi, Mateo. Are you ready to try to do an angle question with, is it an angle?
It's a polygon question.
Oh, a polygon question. Ooh, this is a tough one. All right. I believe in Mateo. He can do this and you'll help him.
And Mateo and I, we've worked problems before, so I think we're going to do very well with this one. Have your calculator ready, all right?
Okay.
All right. So our question says, what is the sum of the interior angles of a 17-sided polygon? I love drawing pictures, but I cannot draw a 17-sided polygon. I can hardly draw a triangle, so I couldn't imagine trying to do a 17-sided one.
I'm trying to draw a hexagon over here. It might be a problem.
So, Mateo, are you familiar with the formula that we can use to... That's right. So what we're going to do, in order to find the sum of the interior angles... We're going to take n, which represents the number of sides in our polygon. We're going to subtract 2 from that. And then we're going to multiply by 180 degrees. So, Mateo, how many sides do we have in this polygon?
17.
Are there any answer choices, if you look over here to my left, are there any answer choices that we can get rid of? I think, do you think we could get rid of 17? Maybe already?
Yeah,
I think so, because we already learned that how many angle, or what is the sum of the 3 angles in a triangle?
17.
They're 180. So we know that it's got to be more than 180, right? So let's go ahead, let's keep going, because these all 3 could be in play. And Mateo, what is 17 minus 2?
15.
Good, thank you. And then let's go ahead and multiply the 180 by the 15.
Okay, yeah.
And perfect. When we multiply the 15 by 180, we get 2,700. 100 degrees. So that is the sum of all 17 angles in a triangle. Or not a triangle, silly, Ms. Shawshak. In a 17-sided polygon. Thank you for working this problem with me. I know it was a little bit difficult, but you did a great job. Bye. We'll see you hopefully next time.
I hope so too.
All right. So, Ms. Prado.
Yes.
Do you have a problem for us?
I barely got it done in time, but yes. Okay. So I have to draw my hexagon on my GE. This is going to be a good time.
We are not artists. We give a shout out to all the art teachers out
Absolutely.
There.
Absolutely. Shout out to all.
Because your job is very, very difficult. We cannot draw those pictures. We have a caller, too, that might want to help you.
We have a caller. Okay. Mm-hmm. Who's my caller? We have Jasmine?
We're not artists. We give a shout out to all the
Jasmine, we need you to turn your device down a little bit, hun.
What?
Just turn the device that you're watching the show on down, but keep your phone, obviously, volume up. Okay. All right, hi, Jasmine. How are you?
I'm good.
Okay, we're going to do some math together. Are you ready? Okay, and did you say you're from Miss Apple? Let's see, it says you're from Miss Applegarth's class?
Yes.
At Benito. Very nice. Okay. All right, determine if each statement about a regular hexagon, drawn very beautifully, may I add, is true. And this says 3x degrees, okay? So it says the sum of the interior angles of the figure is 180. We're missing 1,080. 1,080 degrees. So I'm going to start with A because that just makes sense, right? And if you'll remember that we just learned that the formula for finding the sum of the interior angles of a regular polygon is N minus 2 times 180, right? Now, here comes, are you ready for the hard question? How many sides does a hexagon have?
Oh, that is tough.
Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What do you got? She probably can't see my beautifully drawn hexagon. So a hexagon has 6 sides, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to plug in where it says N. It's asking for the number of sides. So it's going to be 6 minus 2 times 180. Do you know what 6 minus 2 is? Right off the top of your head.
4.
She's killing it. So it's going to be 4 times 180. Okay, so I could do some estimating right now because that's pretty close to 200 and know that it's not going to be 1,080. But I'm going to do it legally, but right away, I'm like, that's not going to be 1,080. All right, it's going to be 720 degrees when you take 4 times 180. So this one's false. Are you following me?
Yeah.
All right. All right, so A, false, not true. Let's go on to B. It says each angle measures 120 degrees. So how we could find out what each angle measures is take the total, this total here, the total sum of the interior angles, and we're going to divide it by what? The number of sides. Okay? So what did we say? Okay. What did we say the number of sides was again? It's a hexagon. How many sides does a hexagon have?
6.
So we're going to take our answer from A when we figured out the sum of the interior angles of this regular hexagon, and we're going to divide it by 6, okay? And that's going to give us the answer of, you know what it is? 720 divided by 6?
Okay.
You can use a calculator.
120.
She did it perfectly. So this one, each angle measures 120 degrees, is absolutely lutely true. All right, we got one more, and you are killing this. So it's going to ask, does X equal 360? So it's what it's saying is, does X equal 360? So what we're going to say is we know that this angle right here, this one right here, It says it's 3x. So our angle is going to be 3x for letter C. 3x equals 120 degrees. Do you know how to solve a one-step equation?
Yeah.
Okay, how do you solve this one-step equation? We got 3x equals 120. What are you going to do? Divide both sides by 3. We do an inverse operation to isolate the variable. And 3 divided by 3 would go away, right? 3 divided by 3 would become 1. You could write 1x, but you certainly don't need to. And then 120 degrees divided by 3 would be what?
1.
40. So, no, it does not. X definitely does not equal 360 degrees. That is false. And you just tackled a pretty serious question about determining the interior angles of a regular polygon. I mean, hexagon in this case. Hexagon. Yes. All right. Great job. Thank you so much, Jasmine, for calling in. I think she might have been a first-time caller, and she did outstanding.
She really did do a great job. All right. Well, I have another problem.
You do.
Should we go and take a look at it?
I think so.
All right. So, if we can look at the board, I'll show you this awesome problem. I really enjoy this one because this one is a right angle, and we are simply solving for x. So let's go ahead, let's take a look. And because it is a right angle, I know that the sum of these two angles have to be equal to 90. And I'm going to go ahead and add 4x plus 26. So I'm going to go ahead and do the inverse operation, and I'm going to subtract 26 from both sides of my equal sign. And when I do that, 90 minus 26 is equal to 64. I bring down the 4x, and now we're going to have to undo this division by using the inverse. So the inverse of multiplication is division. So we will divide both sides by 4. And when I divide 64 by 4, I get 16. So x is equal to 16. I always go back to my question and I make sure that I'm solving for x and they haven't asked me to find the angle measurement, because sometimes they ask for the angle measurement, sometimes they ask for x. So it's very, very important to make sure we know what, in fact, we are solving for. All right. So this was a fun problem.
Oh, yes. And I think it's time that we thank Mathnasium for sponsoring us here at Math Homework Hotline.
I agree. I think we should. They're a fabulous company. So let's go ahead and let's give a shout out to Mathnasium for all of the wonderful things they do for our students. And let's make math a priority this school year and discover why over a million parents have trusted Mathnasium to transform their children's math skills and build their confidence. They have live face-to-face instruction. It's offered both live in the centers, or you can do it online. Just call for a free assessment at one of the nearby locations. They have them pretty much everywhere in Hillsborough County. There's one in Brandon, Carrollwood, Lutz, New Tampa, Riverview, South Tampa, and West Chase. So be sure to give them a call. They're fabulous to work with. Great, great, great organization, great people. All right. So do you have another question, Ms. Prado, that you'd like to work?
I want to talk about the exterior angle theorem. So I'm still writing it out here. So the sum, okay, so let's just go ahead and let's go to my board. All right, what is the value of x in the diagram below? So we're trying to find out what this is. So I'm going to teach you a cheater way to do it. Okay, so the exterior angle theorem states that the sum of the remote interior angles, the sum of the remote interior angles will equal the exterior angle. Okay? So when I tell the kids, they're like, wait, what does that mean? Remote interior. First of all, let's talk about exterior and interior. I think that's important. So when you talk about, most kids have learned interior paint, and they know that interior paint goes inside. See how it has in the word? Interior paint goes inside. So when we're talking about interior angles, we're talking about the angles that are inside. We know what these two are, 124 and 26, but we don't know what he is, okay? So we do know that the exterior angle theorem tells us that the sum of the two remote interior angles will equal the exterior angle. So what it's saying, and then kids are like, okay, so I understand now. Interior angles are inside, but what does that mean, remote? Well, think about the remote, the clicker at home, right? You got the clicker at home. What do you use the clicker for? For going across the room, right? The other side of the room. If you could reach out and touch it, you wouldn't need a remote. So remote means the ones that are far away from it. Not this angle. That angle it could reach out and touch, wouldn't need a remote for. But these two angles that are the far away opposite angles inside the triangle, they will add together to equal x. Okay, so let's do that. So we're going to say that x will equal 124 plus 26, because that's what the remote interior angles are. When you add that together, you'll get x equals 150 degrees. Now, so I'm gonna teach you now. Let's say it's the last question of the test, and you're pretty sure you aced this one, right? You're like, I know I got an A on this test. I'm gonna get that hundo. My adults are gonna be raging proud of me, correct? So what you can do is you can check this, because look, Carrie, these are on a straight line, so they're supplementary, right?
Oh, yeah.
So if this one is 150, they would have to add together. These two angles here would have to add together to be 180.
Right.
So if he's 150, that makes him 30, correct?
Right.
So now, what did we learn earlier? The interior angles have to add to 180. Remember when I took that yellow triangle and turned the angles all together and it made a straight line?
Right.
So now we can start adding up. We've got 124 plus 26 plus 30. And guess what? When you add those together, it'll equal 180 degrees. Okay? So we just checked to make sure that, is that correct? Did these three add to 180? Do these two add to 180? Yes, we did it. So we got 150 degrees is the value of x. And it's like a fun puzzle game, wasn't it?
Oh, it was really fun. I love that.
I think we have a caller.
Oh.
Hi. Is this Hamish? Hamish? Hamish. Hi, Hamish.
Yes.
This is Hamish from Benito, Miss Applegarth. You got a quick question that you can do with him?
We can try to do this quick. Are you ready?
Yes.
Go for it.
All right, awesome. So what we have here is we have a triangle. If we could look at the board, I'm going to show you my problem.
Yeah.
So we have a triangle, and one of the angle measurements is x. One of the angle measurements is 2 times x. And then the measurement of the angle that we know, the third angle, is 66 degrees. So what we want to figure out is what the measure is of the two missing angles. So what do you think we should do first?
Well, I think we should
figure out what x. Right, we need to figure out what x is. So I'm going to go ahead and write an equation. We learned that the interior angles added up to 180 degrees. So let's go ahead and let's write that out. X plus 2x plus 66 equals 180. Do you agree with this?
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, so now what's our next step? What should we do next?
We should take the 66 from 180.
Okay, I can subtract the 66 from the 180. Good. And when we do that, what do we get?
We get 140.
All right, I think you are right.
Yeah.
All right.
Then divide it by 3.
Right, because we have 3x here. We have to remember there's a little invisible 1 there, and we'll divide it by 3. And when we divide 114 by 3, what do we get?
We get 48.
38. Awesome job. You're a rock star. Perfect. So now, was our question asking us to find X? No, it was asking us to find the two missing measures, which one of them happened to be X. So we know that this angle here is going to be 38 degrees. Now, how can I find that one? Good. So we can do 2 times X, and that will equal 2 times 38, which is
76.
Awesome job. So our second missing angle is 76 degrees, and we have finished the problem. Great job. Thank you so much for helping me.
Okay.
See you next time.
Good job. That was great. Okay, so we have some winners.
I love winners.
Winners! All right, so from, oh, what a cool name, Valor.
Ooh, I love it.
From Maniscalco. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then we have Juliana from, or Juliana, sorry if I mispronounced, from York. And then don't forget, I think it's Yadidia, maybe? Okay, all right, from Lutz.
That's Yadidia!
Yadidia! Oh, good, see?
Shout out to fourth period.
Yeah, did ya?
Thanks for calling in.
What pretty, some good look. There's some nice names on that. All right. I think I have time for really quick one more question.
Awesome.
Okay. So what, remember I was just talking about remote interior angles. One of the remote interior angles of a triangle is 26 degrees. The exterior angle is a right angle. We know that because it's got a square. What is the measure of the other remote interior angle? So I know that a right angle is 90 degrees. Remember? That's just one of those things we've memorized, hopefully. And we know that the two remote interior angles are going to add up to the exterior angle. So it's going to be 90 will equal X plus 26. And now it's a very simple one-step equation, right? We're going to just subtract 26 from both sides to isolate the X variable. Because whatever we do to one side, we have to do to the other in solving equations. And we're going to get X equals, I believe, 64.
I think that's right.
64 degrees. So he would be up there. And then, of course, you could also, if this one's 90, this one would be 90 because they have to add to 180. You could add those up and make sure that that's a 64 degrees, a very large degree symbol. Okay, that would equal 180 there. All right. So what's on the docket for next week? What do we got?
Next week is going to be really exciting. We're doing the Law of Exponents.
The Law of Exponents. Woohoo! And our theme will be St. Patrick's Day.
That's right.
So
that's about it for us tonight.
Yeah, that's about it for us tonight. Go Bolts. They're playing in just a little tiny bit.
And thank you guys so much for calling in. See you next week.
Yeah, we will definitely see you next week, and we'll be wearing all the green.
We will be wearing lots of green.
And I am excited to find out who our Teacher Jemmy winner will be.
I know. I can't wait to see who our new student winners are also.
Well, wasn't it? Well, I've already forgotten the name, but we had a student winner this week. But yeah, but which period of the Jemmy winner? So that they can get that food, right?
That's right.
Okay.
So thank you guys so much for tuning in. We can't do this show without you. It makes it way more fun. Call in next week.
We'll see you then. Have a great night.